MLB Network is your exclusive home for postseason baseball. It's the second game of the National League Championship Series between the Chicago Cubs and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci. Briefly here, a glance at the two starters who will get the ball here in this one. With that, a look at the Cubbies' starting lineup. Harold, what's the key for them today?
Well, for me in this game, it comes down to runners in scoring position. If you're able to pick up the runners in scoring position, clearly you're going to score runs, right? But there's many ways to do it. Just hit that ground ball up the middle when they're playing back with the runner on third, and before you know it, you've added on, and now you've allowed your pitcher to pitch his game. That's all they need to do.
Rich Hill is on the mound for game two. Harold, what do you got?
Well, he's got a nasty 12-6 curveball. It's one of those we call a yellow hammer that just starts at the top and hammers down. It's going to be pretty filthy. I'm looking forward to watching it. And if he's able to throw it effectively, he'll have a great game. All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the Dodgers. And a shortstop, Corey Seager. They say this kid doesn't even have a heart rate. He's so calm, so smooth. He so lets the game come to him. But I like how he catches the ball. He makes all the plays, and the bad hops, he's going to make those too.
Digging in, the switch hitter, number 8. This will be his first trip to the plate in this one. Here it comes on 1-1. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Should be a picture perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
That's a high strike on a curveball right there. If he continues to throw that pitch, we won't be mentioning his name very much longer in this game. He's going to have to get that ball down to be effective.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. And a fastball just a bit high.
He's up in the zone a lot right now. Sometimes that can be effective, but I think you have to be careful with that, especially during a day game where the ball tends to carry a lot more.
Chopped weakly to the left. To his left, Turner. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. At the plate, Chris Bryant. Sharp ground ball to third. Turner's got it. On to first, and there were 2 down. 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Sent on the ground out to second. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And a great job to stick with it as he's able to make the play for the third out. Three up, three down for the Cubs. The Dodgers coming up, and we are scoreless. Time now to check out how the hometown Dodgers line up in this one. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Yeah, Matty, you've got to keep an eye on Yasiel Puig. He's certainly a guy to watch out there in this lineup. Everything he does makes them click. When he's swinging the bat well, they just go.
John Lester will be on the bump for game two of the series. HR, what's the word on him?
Well, Matt, he's got five pitches, and I love the fact he mixes them well. And we'll just see if he's on today. That means he's throwing strikes with all of them, and he'll have a dominant game if he does so. Let's take a look at the Cubbies defensively, brought to you by Majestic. In this day and age, with analytics and the shift applied all over the field, this team is old school. They may be a dinosaur. They don't shift as much as everybody else. They play that stationed, standard baseball.
Stepping in, Chris Taylor. He'll match up with John Lester now to lead off the inning. 1-1 on its way from Lester. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. 2-1, here's Lester's offering. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
He's only four pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
Three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. Now here's the pitch. Hit back up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit. So the Dodgers get their leadoff hitter on base to kick off the inning.
Well, here he goes again. Here's that guy, leadoff base hit. He's having a nice postseason. He is really locked in right now.
Here's Corey Seager. Nobody out, runner on first. Oh. 2-1 pitch is a fastball off the plate away, and it's 3-1 now.
3-1. This guy, he's a good hitter. This is the kind of count that gets him excited.
A 3-1 coming from Lester. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul, shy of the wall. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. To second for one. On to Rizzo, and it's a double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
In now, Justin Turner. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. High in the air into shallow left center. Calling for it, Zobrist. And the inning is over. An inning in the books. Scoreless on MLB Network. Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. On the ground to the left side. And it's through for a base hit. They'll have the leadoff man aboard to start the inning. So a base hit to kick things off here, and there's a man aboard to start out their half of the second. Here's Ben Zobrist now. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Now another 1-2. Very weakly on the ground. Throw on to first in time, one away. Coming to the plate now, Addison Russell. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
He chased on that pitch right there, 1-1. He's probably going to try to get him to do it again right here on 1-2.
The 1-2 pitch, and he got him. And with two away, let's check in with our up-to-the-minute playoff bracket. And you can see our series at 1-0 as things are starting to heat up here as we get later into October. Settling in now, Jason Hayward. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. The 1-2 pitch. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. And set up behind the plate is Ricky Holiday, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Now, Matt, I'm telling you, I watch Ricky Holiday call games. I start thinking about hockey. Top shelf. That's him. He's going to call everything up in the zone. Top shelf Ricky.
And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
So he threw the slider darting away to him two times in a row. Now I don't think he'll go for it again. I'm looking for something hard inside on this pitch.
Here comes the payoff pitch down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. That's lifted the other way out to left. Granderson is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One left for the Cubs. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Into the box, number 35. And he's ready to take his first cuts. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
Well, when you're behind in a count like this pitcher is, it's a good time to work in something off speed if you're confident in it. Most hitters are looking for fastball.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Grounded back up the middle. And a good throw gets him one gone. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. And a neck-high fastball that time.
That's a good take on that fastball there. You know he's looking for something up there to drive, but that was just a little above his happy zone. Not everyone has the discipline to hold back on those.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. On deck, the man they've all come to see, Yasiel Puig, waiting next. Bottom of the second here with no score. And a fastball misses there, ball four. Stepping into the box, Yasiel Puig. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Swing and a high pop-up. Could be tough back behind third. Bryant ranges back and he has it for out number two. At the plate, Curtis Granderson. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. A runner on first with two away. Hard on the ground towards short. Russell's got it. Throw not in time as he's able to leg it out.
Well, that's called smelling a base hit right there. He beats out an infield single. Not everybody hustles out of the box, but he darn sure knew he better, and he did.
Stepping in now, Logan Forsythe. Oh, had him off stride that time, and it's one and two.
Well, he's got himself in a little bit of a jam, but I tell you what, he does as good a job as anybody. First and second, two outs. Now watch how he pitches on the corners and tries to get himself out of this.
Working for the punch out and the offering down the third baseline.
That's probably not what he wants to do with two strikes right there with the fastball. He is fortunate he just fouled it off.
Here he comes again, 1-2. Hit out towards second. Baez has it on to first, and the Dodgers come up with nothing as that ends the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two men left on. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied 0-0. Not far from us here at Dodger Stadium, the beautiful beaches of Southern California. Thanks again for joining us on MLB Network. So striding in, Javier Baez, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And a curveball that time that broke too low.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Now the pitch. This one's down to third. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Ready now, John Lester. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Third inning, no score to this point. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. And the fastball easy to lay off that time, 2-2.
Well, these are just extra pitches that are just going to add to your pitch count. He's not trying to work around him, and no reason to, but sometimes you just lose the strike zone for no apparent reason.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swing, and that's hit out of play up into the plaza level.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Swing and a liner. Another 2-2 offering. Pulled toward right center field. Taylor is there now, and he has it, two gone. Striding in once again, number 8, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Three and one, here it is. He likely had ball 4 that time, but couldn't hold back on the swing, so that moves the count to 3-2 now. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
Oh, that's one he's going to want back right there. A fastball right in your wheelhouse, and you foul it off.
Again, he sends it out of play. Once again, a 3-2. Another one sent foul. A payoff pitch one more time. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a 2-out base runner.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Here's Chris Bryant now, 0 for 1 here in the early going. Two out with the man at first. Grounded to third. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Cubs strand one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Coming to the plate now, Rich Hill, as we move on to the bottom of inning number 3. And the pitch. Hits this one hard the other way. Throws in time, and that's out number 1. Digging in to try it again, Chris Taylor. He reached on a single in his first try. Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him. A ball and 2 strikes. A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. Lays off. 2-2 now.
I like that they went away with that pitch right there. They really tried to tie him up on that previous pitch, so he was probably what we call inside conscious. He didn't get a strike there, but I'm guessing he was looking for another ball in.
And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Bottom of inning number 3, 0-0 our score. Fly ball out to straightaway right. And Hayward will put this one away for out number 2. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Corey Seager. Lester gets the sign. Here's the 1-1. Takes a high fastball for a strike. On the ground, softly towards second. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. So they go down without a whimper here. We'll move ahead to the 4th inning now in game 2. And we are tied 0-0. Back here with Harold Reynolds and Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, as the left-handed hitting power threat Anthony Rizzo starts out the inning. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled back. Another payoff pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Digging in for his second at bat, Wilson Contreras, a base hit in his first trip. Ready with the 0-2. And this one's in the dirt. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Set to deal on 2-2. Got him. Ready for another chance. Ben Zobrist comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Swing and a liner, but foul. Has a look, now the pitch. Swing and a little tapper that rolls foul, so a good job to fight it off and stay alive. Another try at 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes, that elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time you get the result that you saw right there, a big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Into the box now, Addison Russell. And that misses, 2-1. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play.
That was a good pitch to hit. He wants that one back. He was just a little bit late on it.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Line drive to left. And this gets right through him, and that may be a run. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. And he's safe.
Well, that's the difference between a harmless error and a costly one. With the bases empty, it doesn't hurt that much, but with a man on, that allows a run to score.
Into the box, Jason Hayward. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The next 3-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Granderson is under it. And that's the third out. Only one in the inning for the Cubs. To the bottom of inning number four we go. It's the Cubs 1 and the Dodgers nothing. Now at the plate, Justin Turner. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 3-1 coming from Lester. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Stepping up to the plate, number 35. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
Look, Matt, this guy's got a great sinker. Here's the key. He's got a runner on first base. This is where you can get that ground ball double play. Make him chase that hard sinker and hit it into the dirt and turn one over for you.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. No runs, two hits, and two errors thus far on the Dodger line score. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
In now, Yosemite Grandal, 2-1.
Ball three. This is one of those rare hitters counts we've seen in this game. They're just having a difficult time getting it going.
Here comes the 3-1 pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play.
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the win if he starts looking for it in there.
And another foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
Well, that's three foul balls in a row. He's definitely battling up there.
The 3-2 one more time. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
So stepping in, Yasiel Puig, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Squared that one up just a little late. And there's a pitch down in the dirt for ball number two.
Hey, two walks in this inning already, so he can't expect to stay out there much longer if he puts somebody else on. We'll see if he can find it.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Two and two count. Here it comes. This is line to left, and that's in there. Base hit. Turner rounds third and is digging for the plate. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
Well, that's a nice hit. We're right back where we started with that RBI base hit. The game is tied.
Stepping in now, Curtis Granderson. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Zobrist giving chase, and that's the second out of the inning. Digging in now, Logan Forsythe. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Here's the 1-1. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. Lester sets. 2-2 on its way home. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Hayward on the run, and that ends the inning. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. We played four full, all tied at 1-1. Here's Javier Baez. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Needed a sand wedge for that one. Swung on and missed. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Yeah, it really does, Matt, but this offense isn't helping him too much. It sort of feels like the next team to score is going to win this thing.
Nope. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. And now pitch on the way. Tries to go the other way as this is hit in the air down the right field line. Throw into second. And he'll get in there safely.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splintered, but instead he muscles the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt he'll take it.
Standing in, John Lester. He's 0-for-1 thus far. One run, two hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Come on. Now a bunt attempt here. Turner gloves it. A quick out number one. Digging in once again, number 8. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he struck him out. Here's Chris Bryant now. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. Hoping to keep it tied. Here it comes. And this one's in the dirt. No advance here, but it's 3-1 now. Set. Here's the 3-1. And, oh, he thought he'd work the walk, but it's a called strike two now.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with a base open to work with.
Runner in scoring position at second with 2 down. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Stepping in, Rich Hill. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. Two and one. Here's Lester's offering. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play. So the count goes to 2-2 now. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Standing in now, Chris Taylor. Ball two. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Into the box now, Corey Seager. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And he shoots this back into center field for a base hit. And the two out base hit will bring in Justin Turner to bat next.
That was terrific. You always hear keep your hands inside the baseball. That's a perfect example. The ball was in and he took it back up the middle. You can't do that if you don't keep your hands inside the baseball.
Into the box, Justin Turner, and a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Set to deliver on 2-1. Foul back. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. Hit high in the air down the right field line. Hayward coming on. He makes the play and that'll end the inning. Dodgers leave one. We've played five full, tied at one aside. Digging in to try it again, Anthony Rizzo comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Now a swing and a hard-hit grounder, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Well, you gotta like how this inning's starting off. He starts the inning with a pretty high pitch count, and your first guy to the plate makes him work. This is playing right into your hand right now on the offensive side.
Fouled back. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. A hit in two tries so far. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And that's going to be all for our starter, Rich Hill. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first. And the best he can do is a no decision in this one. Brandon McCarthy enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. In now, Ben Zobrist. And now there's ball four as this goes straight to the backstop. Ready once again, Addison Russell. It's been an 0 for 2 effort for him to this point. First and second now, one man out. In there at the letters, one and two now. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. Ready now, two-strike pitch on its way. And here's a ball hit in the air. Seager backs up and takes care of it, two away. Here's Jason Hayward now. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. From the belt, kicks and deals. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Grandal has it. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Cubs strand a couple. Score remains deadlocked at one. Ready for another chance? Number 35. He's batting cleanup in this one, but we'll get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just a single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
And he takes ball two, and it's two and one. Well, it's been a good outing so far, but he hasn't really racked up the strikeout totals that you might think, Dan.
Yeah, it amazes me how every game you pitch can be so different, Matt. Sometimes it feels like guys can't touch you and you're just punching everyone out. But other times, you don't have your good stuff and you really rely on movement and location to get outs. That's been the case for him today, and it's really working.
And this inning starts with a solid base hit. So the leadoff man reaches in their half of the sixth. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. Couple of walks for him thus far. Leadoff man aboard here in a 1-1 ball game. Weak grounder back to the mound. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. In now is Yasiel Puig. He's 1 for 2 in the ball game. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw in time at first for out number two. In is Curtis Granderson. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2. A man on third with two down. Hit down the line at first. Rizzo was there, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for L.A. Score remains tied 1-1. Back here at Dodger Stadium. It's on to the seventh now in game two, but before we start, there's a look at our game summary to this point. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Javier Baez, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Outside, 2-1. Set to deliver on 2-1. And a good swing there as this is deep down the line in right, but this is going to wind up out of play. Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Alex Avila is into the on-deck circle now as he'll pinch hit for the pitcher, Lester. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2.
Well, both starters are out of the game, but you know, it's so different today. Now you almost want to get to the bullpen before you extend that starter. At least that's how it seems most managers play it these days.
Pitch on its way to Avila. Wouldn't bite on a good sinker that time that missed.
Ball three to the nine hitter. He's got to know he's going to come after him and throw him a strike. He does not want to walk the nine hitter with the leadoff guy sitting on deck and a chance to get this inning going for them.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Digging in once again, number 8. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. And easy take there. And it's 3-1 now. Chris Bryant would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Good looking sinker on the inside corner. Two out, nobody on. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Pedro Strop gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seven. Now at the plate, Logan Forsythe, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut. And it looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. Caught off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Ready now with the payoff pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. Zobrist sprinting after it. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Had to go a long way to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track data. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 120 feet to bring it in. No doubt that grab saved extra bases. Adrian Gonzalez will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Chris Taylor. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Contreras is under it. Two down. Striding in once again, Corey Seager. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. One and one, here it comes. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Two one, here it is. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And he misses with it, ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
At the plate, Justin Turner. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. So they let him off the hook here by scoring no runs despite the two walks. Eighth inning coming up. All tied at 1-1. Brandon Morrow enters the game from the pen, and because this is a non-save situation, it's evident that they're just trying to get him some work after having not thrown in several days.
Yeah, and this is all about just getting him some work, guys. He hasn't had a chance to come in and close a game out for several days now, so they're just hoping they can keep him sharp and give him a chance to pitch in a real game situation here.
Gets up for the 3-2, and a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
And this is fouled at the plate.
That's a big fastball, obviously, and we're going to see this reliever throw it a lot.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. This is skied out toward right. Puig's got a read on it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Cubs are down in order. Still tied, one apiece. Mike Montgomery is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Now to the plate, number 35. He singled his last time up. Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. 1-2, here it comes. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Stepping in now, Yosmani Grandal. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. One out, nobody on. And he lays off, ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
In now is Yasiel Puig. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Set. Here's the 3-1. Right over the middle, knee high.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that runner in first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. And he misses with it. Ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
Hey, that was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Kike Hernandez will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to, and that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
Settling in now, Logan Forsythe. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Ah. into center field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. Rondon heads for the plate. But it is not in time as they take the lead here in the late going.
Well, that's a huge base hit. Anytime you get a hit late in the game to give you the lead in the ball game, you feel good about yourself, and his teammates are pumped up as well.
Andre Ethier will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Two men are on with two men out. And a big strikeout there as they'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. Game two heads to the ninth inning. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Cubs 1. Kike Hernandez will stay in the ballgame now and take over in left field. Kenley Jansen comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Lights out, baby, lights out.
Ben Zobrist will be the first one to greet him here, as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. Set. Here comes the 1-1. And oh, look out as he has to hop out of the way of the fastball there. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
Down by a run, your guy needs to get on any way he can. His mentality has to be to shrink the strike zone to like the size of a soup can. No reason to swing at a pitcher's pitch.
Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. Way out in front. Count is full. Here's the pitch. Just hung in there on that one. Another full count pitch home. Dribbled to the right side. That's foul, so the battle will continue. Ready now with the payoff pitch. He spoils another one and will do it again.
He's just fouling them off till he gets something he wants to hit.
Payoff pitch one more time. On the ground up the middle, Seager scoops it up, throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Here's Addison Russell. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. The set and the 1-1 pitch. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Ready to deliver the 1-2. That one misses, and I think a ballpark full of umpires disagrees. It's 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. This ball will be chopped foul. Now another 2-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. The 2-2 one more time. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Standing in now, Jason Hayward. Swing and a line drive, but foul. A sold-out crowd, 56,000 strong at the start, all up in L.A. Now a swing by Hayward, but he got out in front a little too much as this will hook into the seats, a foul ball and right. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, we were really treated to a good one today. Bottom of the eighth proved to be the difference, though, and a good job here in the ninth to close the book on this one.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. And there's no better time of year to come up big for your team than in the postseason. And that's exactly what this man did. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and lift your team to victory. He was certainly a big factor here, and it was pretty cool to see.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The Dodgers have evened up this league championship series at two games apiece, so that'll just about do it. For my partners Harold Reynolds and Dan Plesac, this is Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching a presentation of MLB Network. So long, everybody.